My name is Dorothy Burns. A friend of mine recommended you as the best mystery-solving detective out there. I'm calling you regarding an extremely sensitive issue. My son Peter's fiancée, Lily Murdoch, is using dark magic. She always leaves the house before sunset, and you won't find a single clear picture of her. Each one is blurry. Cats go crazy when she's around. You have every right to call me an overprotective mother, but listen to this. Once I accidentally touched Lily's hand and felt cold. My son has changed a lot, not for the better. Peter thinks I'm crazy and isn't going to call off the wedding. Please, you must do something. We have only a couple of days before the wedding.
I'm going to call an ambulance. Please find some ammonia. Maybe we can bring her around.
The ambulance has arrived. We must take her for an examination. I'll go talk to the doctors.
Thanks for your help. I got sick the moment I felt this cold touch again. It was like someone started draining my energy. I want you to find evidence of Lily's use of dark magic in the dorm where she used to live. Hurry, you should do it while we're away. And take this, it may be useful.
I love living in the dorm, though sometimes it's not comfortable. By a happy coincidence, there's a pool here, and I love swimming so much. I'll remember that day for the rest of my life. Peter invited me to a candlelit dinner. We were chatting, music was playing, and suddenly, the rain. Then I felt such vast love for my fiancée. Peter asked me to move into their big house where he lives with his mom. Maybe we're rushing, but I'm happy. I don't have much stuff, just clothes and books, so the move was quick. Soon I'll be wearing a white dress. My life has turned into a fairy tale with Peter as Prince Charming. The preparations for the wedding are in full swing. Can't wait! Set me free! Set me free!
I'm Alex Hughes. Nice to meet you, and thanks for the help. I work here. The part-time job helps me financially, but strange things have started happening here a lot, like this suddenly burst pipe. Since you're a private detective, I'd be happy to answer any questions you have. I'm Lily's friend and roommate. Lily had an accident recently. She fell in the pool and started drowning, but she was rescued and recovered. Yeah, I know Peter. He and Lily are such a nice couple. There are legends that shadows like that circle over souls of those who have returned from the dead and soon will be taken back. But I'm pretty sure that's nonsense. I know a doll maker who makes great dolls that look like real people. If anyone can help you, it's him. His store isn't far from here. Take this. I found it here. It may be useful.
Hello, I'm Frank, a doll maker. My specialty is living dolls. Yeah, Peter. I made one for him not so long ago. These dolls do look like real people, but it's an illusion. It's often the only consolation for people who have lost their loved ones. I create a replica of somebody who has passed, and their relatives feel better. It's like no one has died. People talk to the dolls, share their worries. Some clients even claim the dolls are great conversationalists. But it's only their imagination. Dolls can't talk. I even made my wife's replica. Katie died long ago. I don't feel so lonely with the doll by my side. Sorry, I'm a terrible host. I'll go make you a cup of tea.
Yes, guilty. I used to breathe life into the dolls. I did it with Katie, too. But the dark spirits took her to their world. My pupils are not allowed to use the dark magic folio. I barely know how to handle it myself. Do you want to find the site the ritual took place? Go to the cemetery and find Lily's grave. That's the only spot you could bring a doll to life. I didn't want this to happen to anyone else. That's why I've never used dark magic since. My living dolls are just replicas, soulless reminders of the departed. I'll pay a visit to my master. He knows for sure if there's a way to interrupt the soul's transmigration process. Oh, my last attempt to bring someone to life didn't end well. You can make your own living doll at my workshop, but don't breathe life into it. You know how dangerous it can be. If you make a doll, you can use it in the future. A special ritual allows you to control your creations, even from a distance. Here, this is the key to my workshop.
take the needles out of the doll so I can find peace. I knew it! Good thing I decided to follow you. This is none of your business. Stay here forever!
Thank you. I'm Katie. You're so brave. Fighting dark energy in Astral, the world of spirits, takes a lot of courage. Getting here is next to impossible, and a living person mustn't stay in this world for long. I've been here for too long, so there is no way I'm getting out of this cursed place. But you're still a human, and thus you do have a chance of freedom. Use a portal in the picture to get to the ominous forest, then find the lifeless lake. It's your one-way ticket to the human world. I'll be here in case you need anything. Here, take this. It may come in handy.
Frank and Katie were a match made in heaven. They both wanted kids, but Katie couldn't get pregnant. Adoption was the only option. The couple spent months collecting the papers required, but it was worth it. The nursery was ready when Katie got into trouble. Two robbers attacked her, stole her bag, and they thought there must be jewelry there because Katie was holding the bag so tight, but inside there were only adoption papers. Frank almost lost his mind the day he learned about Katie's death. That's why he created a doll, a vessel for his wife's soul. At first, their life ran its course. Katie lived her human life and didn't remember the accident. But happiness couldn't settle down in their house. Dark spirits broke in at night and took Katie's soul. Frank got a severe punishment. He wasn't allowed to be with his love in the afterlife. Dark magic had served him wrong.
I guess this is where our ways part. I'm anchored to this mansion and can't leave it. Once you get to the lake, find a pier. There must be some way of crossing the lifeless lake. The only place with access to the human world. Note that nothing in this world is what it seems to be. Danger lurks at every turn. Goodbye, and take care.
Your determination is getting on my nerves. Enough! You won't succeed in ruining my plans. Have fun here in Astral.
Thank you.
kidding. How on earth did you manage to get out? Well, you're a worthy opponent. I guess I'll have to find another source of energy. Soon I'll have control over Peter and do away with both of you.
Thank you. I feel much better. Please bring me the map. I'll mark the location of Alex's cabin. And could you do me a favor? Please, pop into my doll theater. It opens with a special amulet. What? The dollhouse? Oh, this place is full of information about Alex. The house is small from the outside, but one can easily get in and have a walk around. I'll give you the key. So, what do you say? This is the place. Alex's hideout. She goes in there to hone her magic skills. Don't forget the map. My motorboat is right next to the house. Take it to cross the river. I'm still feeling a bit shaken, so I'll be of no use to you. I'd better stay here. Good luck, and be careful.
time left, but we are close to saving Peter. Alex already has everything set. She's ready to turn him into her inanimate pawn. This cabin is exactly the place Alex acquired her knowledge of magic. I have very little time left, but we are close to saving Peter. Alex already has everything set. She's ready to turn him into her inanimate pawn.
Great. We have the potion. Beware, Alex Hughes. It's a shame it took you so long to find the potion. Alex is now in the Witchy Glade and has already started the ritual. You must find her voodoo doll and burn it. That way you'll make Alex weak and vulnerable. I'm not the best helper, but here, take this. I found this thing in the cabin.
Thank you.
talks a lot. I was obsessed with this doll and lost my head. What was I thinking of? Now it's time to let go of it.